Pom 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 pom.
Tomatoes.
Hello, welcome to video 4. What is Capsule Trace by Channel? So this is going to pretty much wrap up the trace by channel nodes. There's the line trace, the sphere trace, the box trace, and then there's the capsule trace. Now the capsule trace is kind of weird due to the fact that technically it's a sphere, it's just elongated on one end. But the nice thing about it is it does have some uses. Because your player, technically, its collision is set up as a capsule most of the time if you're using character. Using a capsule trace by channel, you can emulate that if you're going to attempt to see if your player can fit somewhere or collides with something. So let's look at this note. The capsule trace by channel starts off with the capsule defined by the size, and it will fire off in whatever direction you want, and then end with another capsule at the end. And you can see where it's hitting right now. I'm hitting based on this little square on the top left right there. You can see that is where our capsule is hitting a collision point. Since I'm tracing my channel, I'm using visibility, and that is the first thing it visibly sees based on the size of this capsule that it can hit. If I was to walk in front of it, we'll see it stops. However, it is only stopping where the little round part or the nose of my character is. And that's because I've set it up by channel, and the body of this character is set to invisible. Not invisible, but not to block visibility, which is the channel I'm checking on. So let's look at it. Capsule trace by channel is pretty simple. Like the other nodes, it takes in a start and the end. It has a radius. The radius determines basically how far around our capsule is going to be. So in this case, when we run this, our radius is from this side to this side. It's the radius of a capsule. We have the height. Now technically this is the half height. This is from the tip of the hemisphere to the end cap. So if we go like this, our half height is basically going to be where this line is to the top. It determines the half height. We could, for example, do 50 for the half height and 50 for the radius. That's going to basically give us a sphere, as you can see here. And of course, if you wanted it taller, your half height would be taller, and then we're going to get a much taller capsule, as you can see here. Trace channel is the channel we are going to trace against for blocking. By default, it's going to be visibility, but of course, you can use any other trace channel that you'd like. Trace complex basically means if it's checked, we're going to test against complex collision. If it's false, we're going to test against simplified. Your meshes and such can have different collision types, complex and simplified. And for the most part, simplified is going to work fine. If you need something that's more dynamic, more than likely you're not going to be using the capsule trace because of its size. So trace complex disabled is probably fine. Actors to ignore is a simple array that we could make, for example, and it simply holds actors that we would like to ignore. In this case, we could do a capsule trace against everyone, and then what we want enemies to be ignored when we're doing the trace, and we only want the landscape, for example. So we might want to make an array and put in the enemies in here or other players, that way we don't have them blocking our trace. Draw debug type is simple. It draws our debug for the duration of either none. In this case, you'll see nothing happening here for my trace. One frame, which means only that frame you'll see the data. Duration, it's going to be the duration of our trace itself, which is normally a couple seconds. And then persistent, which means once it draws this line trace, it will never get rid of it. For the most part, for debugging, you'll have one frame or duration, and you'll have none for your builds. Ignore self is pretty self-explanatory. Disabled by default. And we run this, you're going to notice we have a green line here, and our trace is actually starting and stopping at our sphere. Because the origin point is inside of our sphere, when it tries to trace out, it hits the sphere because it's part of the same blueprint, and it's going to trigger a collision. Once I've enabled ignore self, now you can see it actually interacts, and you can see our debug lines being highly annoying based on the setting for duration. That's why one frame is generally best for debugging collision, like this. Now, if we were to hit something, we're going to get two things on the outside. We're going to get a return value, whether or not we hit something, yes or no. So this one's pretty simple to check against. And then we're going to out hit, which is a hit result. Hit results are covered in a separate video. But for the most part, since this is a single trace for our debugging purposes here, I'm going to print out what we're hitting. Right now we're hitting sphere 2, which is that top left sphere. When I walk into it, now we're hitting the front nose sphere on my player. That is going to wrap up our capsule trace by channel node. It's basically the same as all of our other traces, except a capsule is what is used for the tracing collision type. And by capsule, of course, I mean this fun little guy where it has a diameter and a height. Let me run this again and show you what I meant by collision. Of course, there we go. So, collision. There we go. Our character has a capsule, as you can see. So it is very useful to use the by collision traces when you are going to emulate a character and you want to see if they collide with anything.